All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon. Man, these are some crazy times. Let's talk about it. You know, I haven't done an actual just chat like this for a while. I've been doing a lot of interviews lately. If you want to check them out, man, they've been really fun. I got more coming. Trying to talk to some fans and media guys and players and former players, current players. Just kind of trying to run the gamut of just different perspectives, trying to give you guys a different kind of outlook than the normal run. You know, I think this during the quarantine, I think it's been a unique time to kind of jump on Zoom and do some other things and kind of network and branch out a little bit. So hope you guys are enjoying it. But we got big news today. This is the day that we decided, as both universities collaborated together, to basically end the term civil war when it comes to the Oregon and Oregon State game. And, you know, I'm okay with this. You know, as a guy who I'm an educator and a history guy, and I think it's important to look at these times as kind of a continuation of a learning experience across the nation. And, you know, I'm a big believer in kind of re-examining history and looking at it through different lenses because, you know, as my grandfather said, there's always three perspectives, you know, your version of the truth, somebody else's version of the truth, and the actual truth, because, you know, it's hard for us to see things on the same perspective. So listening and being able to understand different people's stories, I think, is very important. And I think that's kind of one of the other reasons why I really wanted to start doing some of these Zoom calls. You just get a lot of people's different perspectives on things, whether it be on the Ducks or whether it be on social change that's happening. So the Civil War, you know, the reference to it is not necessarily that deeply rooted with the reference of the actual American Civil War that was fought, obviously, between the North and the South. It's the idea of it was termed and coined that, but the reference of it is the same. It's the same idea of it's brother versus brother in some cases, families divided, and so the reference of it is more on those lines. But I really like the idea of moving away from it. I don't like looking at a game like a war. I'm just not even talking about on the connections to the Civil War and to slavery and everything else that's deeply rooted in that term, Civil War. Just having a game be like a war or like a battle or like anything, it is kind of outdated for me. So the term that was used before Civil War, and Kurt Ledecky, who's a great follow, understanding of Oregon history and really dives very deep into the Oregon history, which I absolutely love. He pointed out right off the jump, you know, that, you know, it's basically something that's been used since the 30s and, you know, kind of talking about a post game kind of riot that was happening. And, the headline that came out of it was kind of more about a war. And that's all on Twitter. Go check him out. Kurt Ledecky, great, great guy. But, you know, I guess it was, you know, as I look deeper into it, you know, maybe the first time it was referenced was maybe even in the 20s. But before that, it was called the Oregon Classic or the Oregon State Championship. And I really like Oregon Classic. You know, I put on Twitter that I thought maybe the Platypus Bowl or something like that because they go for the Platypus Trophy. But I kind of like Oregon Classic. You know, it's one of those things. And, you know, Oregon has a wild history. There's a tremendous amount of racism built into Oregon's history. And when you go back into it, you know, there's a lot of changes happening on campus with the renaming of D.D. Hall and renaming of a variety of other things and looking at things through a different lens, looking at paintings in places. Verone McKinley had talked about that a little bit. Looking at paintings, looking at sculptures differently. And, you know, it's a shame when it has to come down to people have to, you know, feel the need to riot and destroy these things because, you know, for years they've been asking for, you know, the perspective to change on some of these things. And, you know, it's about time it does, and I really support it. So, you know, during this time, I think it's really important to just kind of understand and look through different lens, you know, and that's really what I preach about, you know, with my students. And I think, you know, this is a perfect example, you know, Oregon Civil War, you know, there's a lot of connotation there, you know, and the difference between Oregon and Oregon State is deeply rooted as a family who has all had gone through there. My grandmother would never even call it OSU because she called it OAC. You know, she was from the 40s. And, you know, that kind of a thing, like, you know, there was a deep divide very early on. And we see the same thing in Washington because Oregon and Oregon State have a deeply rooted divide, very similar to Washington and Washington State. Washington State and Oregon State are both agricultural land grant schools. Very early on, agricultural basis and the focus on the agriculture, whereas the and in more of a rural location. And they do great work. Oregon State's one of the best schools, I've told students for years, one of the best schools in the world for what they want to study. Science, engineering, I've had plenty of friends go through there and be engineers and scientists. And I mean, it's an amazing, amazing educational experience. And Oregon has its own situation. So the divide is kind of socioeconomic. The divide is also very urban to rural. You know, Eugene is not an urban center, but, you know, historically it is the second to third largest city in Oregon. You know, obviously Portland dominates. Portland's half the population of the state. So, you know, when you look at it, you know, Seattle's in the same boat. So Seattle has this kind of divide between, you know, the Palouse and obviously a major, major metropolitan area. So I do think this is a great situation for Oregon. It's a great situation for Oregon State to kind of come together to agree on this and to listen to the change. You know, Dennis Dixon spoke on this, you know, years ago, and other guys had spoke on this years ago. And so I think it's important that people are kind of coming to perspective on this, changing perspective on it. And so I think it's a great thing. So as a history guy, you know, the Oregon Civil War, you know, historically was, you know, the name of it, call it what you want, really built up this idea that it was a battle. It really built up this idea that it was just a tremendous, you know, engagement between these two forces, you know. And I don't think it needs to be like that. I think it needs to be more of a contest. I think it needs to be, I like the idea of calling it a classic, you know. Those kind of terms really bring out the best in people. And I really love the Civil War, you know, historically, in our state, that matchup, because I really love to see all those people come together. You know, there is a lot of hate that goes back and forth, and there's always extremists on both sides. But I kind of tend to be one of those kids who grew up an extremist because I lived in that household. I grew up a duck, obviously, but I'm inundated. But I also, the older I've gotten, the more I've tried to teach tolerance and understanding and perspective a little bit on that rivalry, because, you know, it is a great rivalry. One of the most played sporting events, you know, between two colleges in the country. I think it's the fifth most played football, and I think it might be the first or second most played in basketball. I think Oregon and Oregon State have played each other more times than like any other schools, or at least in the top five, you know. So, you know, it's just an amazing, amazing thing. And I think this just shows the progress of the willingness of both schools. I think both schools are trying to look into a future direction. You know, I'll just talk on Oregon for a second. You know, the ability, the willingness to move out of Mack Court, you know, said a lot. Obviously, redoing Autzen Stadium felt like a necessity, but, you know, and the upkeep of Autzen Stadium since that point, and the redesigning of it or whatever, but moving out of Mack Court was a signature moment because, you know, that they had embraced history for so long at Oregon with that building, and they'd embraced the history behind it, and the willingness to move on to the new arena really was a culture shift at Oregon, and really a willingness to kind of look into the future. And we've gone through a couple different presidents since then, and I think it really in a new direction for the U of O, and it's pretty exciting to be a part of, you know. Whether or not we're having a football season this year or not, I don't know. Whether or not we're having a basketball season or not this year, whether or not we're having students on campus, these are still question marks. It's June 26th. These are still question marks we don't know about, but I think just having the opportunity for Oregon and Oregon State to come together like this on a name change of something that is something that's branded quite a bit around this area, whether it's newspaper advertisements, whether it's roadside advertisements, whether it's used in a variety of different promotions and other sort of thing. The term Civil War, you know, is not going to be used anymore. So I don't know what it's going to be called, but, you know, I would love to see it go back to that Oregon classic or something just very clean. It doesn't need to be catchy. It doesn't need to be a shtick thing. Platypus is fine, but it's just because the thing has a duck bill. They're from Australia and New Zealand or some Tanzania. So it's like, you know, it's not even relevant of what our, you know, but the beaver is our state animal. It's on our flag, you know, so, you know, calling it the beaver trophy doesn't make a lot of sense from our duck perspective, obviously, but it's whatever it is going to be. It should be fun. It should be something that we can embrace. And I think it should be something that we look at more positively instead of looking at it the negatively. Like, you know, they've changed the Red River Shootout to the Red River Rivalry, you know. And I think that's great because I don't think it needs to be looked at as a negative connotation like these guys are going to war. These are college kids. They're playing a football game. I think we need to kind of keep it in perspective here, speaking on perspective. So, all right, guys. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. I'll continue with the videos. I got more North Dakota State videos coming. I'm going to try to get some Ohio State videos coming in shortly, even some Hawaii talk. And then I'm going to see what I can do with the Pac-12 and try to get some stuff maybe in August, right before when we start talking about the Pac-12, and try to kind of hone it down a little bit and maybe get some talk from a variety of different sources. And I'd love to get some talk on the Beavs on this topic as well. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching Sports Chat 503. Adios.